Good morning. My name is David Hall, and I'm running for Commissioner in District 3. First of all, I'd like to thank all y'all for coming out this morning. And thank you, Brad and GOP, for inviting me to be here to speak and let people get to know me a little bit better. I am a newcomer to politics. Also, I'd like to thank my lovely wife of 25 years, Kim, she's here, and my son, DJ, for getting up early and coming out and helping me get started. They're not used to doing things this early in the morning, but I greatly appreciate it. And for almost 22 years, I've had the great pleasure of not just calling Forsyth County my home, but I've had District 3 has been my home for the last 22 years. You know, my wife and I have been lucky enough to have raised our kids in District 3 and had the great privilege of sending them to the great school system that we have in Forsyth County. They attended all three levels of school, starting out at Midway Elementary, and then graduated from there to Victory Creek Elementary, and then the middle school, and then on to the West Forsyth High School. I can't say enough about our school system. I think it's one of the best in the state. And not only did they get to enjoy the great school system, but the parks and recs that we have in Forsyth County are awesome. We grew up, as probably many of y'all did, we lived at the ballpark. We lived at Midway Ballpark. I coached baseball, football, softball. I didn't coach the cheerleading. Kim left that to Kim, but I coached there for 18 years and loved it. Got to meet a lot of great people and really looked forward to it. My God and family are the two most important things in my life. Kim and I, our family, has for many years attended the Browns Bridge Church. We love worshiping there. That's probably enough about me. I'll get on about my campaign. My campaign is not focused on a burning desire for another title. The titles that drive my choices are the titles I've already earned. I've earned the title of a family man. I've earned the title of a small business owner, successful business owner for 25 years. And also, I've earned the title of a servant leader. My campaign is focused on ensuring that not just my kids, but my grandkids and our future generations are given the same opportunity that Kim and I were given when we moved in Forsyth County nearly 22 years ago. You know, 22 years is a long period of time, and during that time, we had the unique opportunity to witness a lot of changes in Forsyth County, in District 3. We also had to experience an incredible amount of growth in our district. And then there, with that growth, we had some growth was good and some growth was bad. I'm gonna be working on, your commissioner, on the good growth. With all the growth that comes into our area, we're faced with some numerous challenges, but we're also faced with numerous opportunities as well. The hardworking families of Forsyth County deserve a commissioner who, one, will manage the growth, two, effectively, that's a key word, effectively work with all the others in our county, and also ensure that taxpayers have a voice in their local government, because government does belong to the people. And by that, what I mean is that, you know, as I have already received several phone calls from people, and I've asked to meet with people. I look forward to that. Working with the citizens. I take their phone calls or meet with them anytime I can. I listen to their concerns, answer the questions if I can, and give them my opinion if I'm asked. I can tell you one thing I will not do. If I am asked a question, I will not tell John what he wants to hear to answer his question. But that same question that Joe asked me, I'm not going to tell him what he wants to hear. Okay? I'm a straight shooter. I'm a man of integrity. I work with everybody, and I'm passionate about that. I'll be an unwavering advocate for the homeowners of Forsyth County. I'm also working to grow our local economy, and also hold our elected county officials accountable. I understand that the greatness in our communities comes from the citizens, It does not come from elected officials at all. My experience does not count in politics. I told you, this is my first political race. I'm learning as I go, but experience does come in the form of three things. One, as I said earlier, a small business, a successful business person for 25 years, creating private sector jobs, and also volunteering in our community. I think that's really important to get involved, as I am doing. My service on the Board of Commissioners is not a path to another office, I'll tell you that. I'm just doing my duty. Matter of fact, I'll take it a step further. I'll pledge no more than two terms in office. Also have several other pledges I like to make. One being to help the local economy to stay strong and vibrant in our district. We also pledge to hold government accountable. Also pledge to eliminate unnecessary spending. Pledge to help transportation problems that plague our county. We all know, all driving through Forsyth, it's really tough in some areas, especially the south end of the county. And lastly, I'll pledge to work closely with the law enforcement officials and the public safety officials in our county to guarantee the continued safety of the citizens of Forsyth County. You know, we're blessed to live in an awesome county. Forsyth County has so many things to offer. Lakeland here, for example, it's an enormous economic engine. It's a tremendous natural resource to our county. We also have the awesome shopping facilities, the fantastic restaurants, the great schools, as I said, and parks and rec. We also have the awesome hospital. We have the Greenway. What a tremendous asset to the county there. I don't use it, but my wife sure does enjoy it. She goes on it every day. It's a great asset to our community. To me, Forsyth County is not just a dot on a map or just a blip on the radar. But to me, Forsyth County is my passion, it's my community, and it's a place I love to call home. And I'd just like to thank y'all so much for listening to me this morning, and hope y'all have a good rest of your weekend. Thank you very much.
Next speaker of the day is Todd Levent. Come on up, Commissioner.
My name is Claudia Castro. I'm the Managing Director of Smart Growth Forsyth. I've been with the organization for the last, I want to say, almost be 10 years. So with that, I'm going to open up the floor to Todd. I will also like to preface, as it comes to mind, I'm sorry, it was a long day at work, that we did ask the other candidate for District 3 Commissioner, David Hole, to attend. We invited him to attend, and we sent him the same questions that we sent to Todd Levent. And we heard back late last week from Mr. Hole that he had another commitment. So he won't be making it today. We did suggest to him and encourage him to please send us his responses to the questions, which were also made public and are on our website, so everything's on the up and up. We asked him to submit answers to the questions so that we could perhaps read a few of them to you and give you his perspective, but we didn't hear back from him. So I just want to let you know where we stand on that. And I'm going to open the floor now to Todd to give his opening statements. And then myself, Bill Start, who's the Deputy Director of Smart Growth, Dee Rudecci, where'd he go, who's the Treasurer, and Jack Leeson, who's the Environmental Compliance Officer for Smart Growth. They'll all be asking questions from the same playbook that we've posted online and that we've submitted to the candidates.
As you know, we did not do a debate for District 3 Commissioner. And at the time, we had a bit of a problem with scheduling. Since that point in time, the two candidates in District 3 are David Hole and Commissioner Todd Levent. Since the original decision not to have a debate, I wasn't really happy with some of the responses I received from one of the candidates in terms of a public statement they made about why we didn't have this debate. And in response to that, I've decided to give their opponent 15 minutes to talk to you guys.